In Africa, hundreds are dead as a sectarian conflict between Muslims and Christians is escalating. It's even prompting the international community to step in. George Thomas has more on the brewing storm in the Central African Republic.
1,600 French troops are on the streets of the Central African Republic, trying to put an end to clashes between Muslim and Christian fighters. The Red Cross says more than 460 people have died since last Thursday, many of the victims children. Two French soldiers were also killed when they came under attack during an overnight patrol. The fierce fighting has forced some 20,000 people to take refuge at St. Paul's Church in the capital city, Bangui.
We have the impression that some people want to provoke Christians and Muslims to fight with each other. But we say no to this. We advocate tolerance, respect.
Central African Republic is a landlocked nation surrounded by some of the most dangerous places on earth. CBN News visited the country 2 years ago.
Since gaining its independence back in 1960 from the French, the Central African Republic has endured some 11 mutinies, numerous rebellious movements, both in the north as well as in the south. And today, it is one of the poorest countries here on the African continent.
The government of the Central African Republic, a predominantly Christian country, was overthrown in March by Muslim rebels who looted, raped, and killed for months. Despite the presence of French troops who are trying to disarm the militias, there's still plenty of pent-up rage on the streets. Late Tuesday, a mob of young men, reportedly Christians, set fire to a mosque in the capital. The Archbishop is appealing for calm and asking Christians not to carry out revenge attacks against Muslims.
I'm asking Christians to seek peace, to seek pardon, and not to enter the cycle of vengeance that will not be good. Justice exists. I invite everyone to stay calm.
Despite having substantial natural resources like gold and diamonds, most people here are poor, and the country has seen little stability in 5 decades. On Monday, the U.S. military agreed to transport African Union peacekeeping troops to the country to try and end months of instability. George Thomas, CBN News.